What is up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. Today we are here at Highland Brewery for another putter review. This time we have the Latitude 64 Pure. This is possibly, well, from what I know of Latitude 64, this is their most popular putter. Its numbers are 33, negative 11, which is a really interesting numbers for putters because normally they either just turn or they just fade. You don't normally get a negative 11 on a putter, which is kind of a unique feel. It is very rounded over on the top, but it almost has a concave bevel. It's a really interesting putter. I got it in the zero medium because that's what they had available in the shop, but it's already feeling pretty good. This plastic is very grippy. Let's see how it plays. Number one, 216 feet, right there at the bottom of the hill. We're gonna go nice little soft backhand. Hopefully I can control my angles today and so I don't just turn this over, because the negative one on a putter kind of makes me think it's gonna turn a lot. So I'm gonna try to keep this on a hyzer most of today. Look pretty good. Now, to be fair, I threw that in a fan grip, not a power grip. So I might be throwing a lot of fan grips today. We'll see how it holds up to a little bit more power later. Hole two, 230, let's just hyzer flip and try to make it as straight as possible. Well, that's not good. When you have an understable disc that starts to fade, it's gonna fade a long way before it stops. But surprisingly good putter. Hole number three, let's see how the Pure holds an Anheuser. I'm gonna throw it down this left gap. And I'm going to put some forced Anheuser onto it, and we'll see how it flies from there. I think it would hold really well. It was a slightly early release, and the fact that it's a three speed, it kind of overshoots the fairway. So it kind of snuck through the left side for a while. I think hole five is going to be better for the Anheuser shot. All right, it's another par. Thankfully, a par two. So we're one down going into hole number four. Good news. They're doing a lot of coursework and maintaining and making things better. Bad news. There's a thing in the fairway. Hole number four, 218. The good news is, I think though, it's gonna force me to have to throw higher, which is probably gonna be a good thing, because having to go hyzer with a very, very straight putter, you kind of need some height to help it to stall left. And I almost hit it. I threw it so low. After I said, I'm gonna throw this high, and then I threw it really low and almost hit the thing. As far as the Pure goes, very, very neutral. You throw it on some hyzer, it's gonna flip up and hold straight. So it's not really neutral. It is the flight numbers, negative 11. Most people would consider that neutral. I don't consider that neutral, because unless it has a zero and then a very low number, it's not neutral for me, but that's just me. Hole five is another 230. This hole feels like it's gonna shape for this shot, for this Pure. Just a soft little backhand Anheuser, put it on a touch of Anheuser, but then the rest of the time it should just keep holding because of that negative one. Again, this hole's blind, so you don't really know where it finished. It looked like it might have been too overturned, but it could be perfect. Who knows? Hey, look at me go. almost splashed out. That's another birdie. That's three down going into hole number six. So it's almost like we birdied half of them. Just looks on the scorecard a little bit more lopsided than the other. 187 feet. This seems like the type of putter most people are going to want if they're trying to find something that's going to be really, really good for lacing specific lines. Whereas my preferred variation of release is flat to extreme anhyzer. Most people prefer to throw from flat to extreme hyzer. So having a little bit of flip up out of a disc is going to be fantastic for a lot of people. So I can see why the Pure is so popular. Well, the gap, but then I pulled it just a touch. A little bit of headwind, a little bit of anhyzer, a little Pure. It's gonna go further right than you want it to be. Oh man, that looked like it was in for a solid 30 seconds almost. I think I'm gonna have to film that putt too. It putts really clean though. It comes out very fast, very smooth. It's either the plastic or just the three-speed shallowness. I'm used to the two speeds where I kind of have to let them go, and the three speeds tend to just kind of pop. I like the two-speed though. 264. The wind's tricky in here. It feels like it's coming off of this side, which doesn't make any sense because normally they go down the hill, not up the hill, but sometimes, maybe, I guess. We're going Pure on a lot of hyzer because the flip up I'm already seeing tells me that I need to throw it on more hyzer if I'm going to throw it harder. And I'm going to have to throw it harder if I want to go 250 feet slightly uphill. Okay, well, it never got fully to flat, so that's a good thing. That means it's controllable. Because if I start a disc on that much hyzer and it flips up to flat or even turns over, I don't want to throw it. This is controllable. That's a good flight. I just haven't learned to control it yet. It's just right there. Now I just have to get right there. Thrown very flat with a fan grip, it's an amazing throwing putter. I think I would want it in a more premium plastic if I were gonna throw it on a power grip a lot because I'm used to throwing Sky God 4s, which are overstable, and that one is definitely not. Almost had it. Almost saved the par. Though, let's be honest, of all the holes to take a bogey on with a flippy putter, that one's probably it. In the modern era, probably the most popular person to throw and putt with Pure, I think. I could be wrong, but I think it's Kristen Sitar. And she is a big component of the straddle putt. She straddle putts, I think, 100% of the time. And I mean, I straddle putted, and it is nice to have something like this. It kind of just goes far. You spin it and it glides. I think the negative one would get to me if I were to throw it or if I were to staggered stance putt. But on a straddle, I almost needed the extra little bit of just help keep it straight. It's a good putter. I'm not gonna bag it though. More to come. Hole number 8, it's about 200 feet right down there. Like I said, fan grip very, very, very straight on a fan grip.
Don't do it.
And unlike the slightly slower putters, like the P2, like the AVR, just the two speed that still glide putters, you do kind of have to pop it. If you're not very precise and you just kind of chuck it in there, it might not have the glide because it's a three speed. it does need a little bit extra speed to get that glide. Well, number 9, 203, we're gonna talk more once I'm further away from the angle grinder. Soft, I keep throwing this whole soft. 2 under par, let's see if we can make it to 3. This putter might be able to get there. That would be a no, and it rolled almost to the bottom of the hill. That's way down there. I think that's a putt we can make. Well, I finished 1 under par, which is better, I think, than some of the other putters that I am much more comfortable throwing. However, it's not the type of disc or the type of angle control disc that I'd be looking for. It's just a little bit too flippy for me. And to be fair, that could 100% be the plastic. As soon as I started to power it up ever so slightly, it gave me flip and glide that I wasn't really expecting, which could be amazing. But if I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna throw it mid-range or an NV. That being said, the Pure is still a fantastic disc. World champions have putted with the Latitude 64 Pure. Check one out if you haven't had a chance to, but it's not going into my bag. If you enjoy content like this, make sure to like the video. If you want to see new stuff, make sure to comment that down below. Make sure to subscribe. Giveaways for subscribers only, of course. And until next time, see you out on the course.